I was born, praise God, October 12, 1938. Praise God, at 308, praise God, 133rd Street in Harlem, New York, apartment 3B. And praise God, my mother was Ellie Simmons. Praise God, my father, praise God, my God, was Frank Simmons. Praise God, my grandmother was Sophie Simmons. And my grandfather was Wash Simmons. My father's mother and father was Thomas Richardson and Elizabeth Richardson. And praise God, you know, I came to Christ on my 15th birthday. Praise God, because where I grew up, you know, Harlem was a tough place. Now, when you got up in the morning, you see a head, an arm, and a leg. Praise God, maybe cut off in the backyard. Praise God, my God, you see, praise God, my God, people pleading for their life. Praise God, maybe it was a bookie that stole somebody's money, and you hear, please don't kill me, praise the Lord. But you know, if he didn't produce that money, he's dead, praise God. And I thank God, praise God, you know, I was, praise God, my God, a drunkard. I was, praise God, a gang leader. I was a murderer. I was a gambler and devil possessed. Now, as you hear me speaking, you hear me saying, praise God, fast. Praise God. People wonder what I'm saying. You know, when I got saved, I came from a conservative family. And I said, you know, all these people, praise the Lord, hallelujah. It doesn't take all of that. God said, you will say it more than anybody. Praise God. My wife said, I will say it in my sleep. And I believe it because I don't know. Praise the Lord. So I thank God. Praise God. I got saved October 12th. 1952 at 12:45 in the afternoon. I got called into the ministry October 12, 1953 at 3:30 in the afternoon. Praise God, my call to the ministry, I saw houses and people sitting on the stoops, and I saw blood everywhere. And you know what that was? That was the blood of Jesus, praise God, my God, the wanting to cleanse them. The moment I got saved, praise God, I started witnessing to everybody. I went from door to door, praise God, my God, bless you, and saying, do you know Jesus? Praise God. They said, who? Praise God. I said, Jesus, praise God, your wrestler. And I started quoting scripture because, you know, God taught me by himself. Every apostle, praise God, has to be taught directly by God himself. I'd be walking along the street and everything, praise God, would turn gray. Like the clouds would come down. I didn't know. I couldn't see anything else. But the sky would open up. I would see a great big Bible, praise God, with white pages and big black letters and fingers pointing, God's finger pointing to the scripture, praise God. And you know what happened, praise God, that there were no chapters in verses. And I wondered, praise God, my God. Then when I started studying the Word of God, I found that when it was really rewritten in the beginning, there was no chapters and verses. I said, God, that's why. Praise the Lord. They were just put there for us to be able to memorize. Praise God, my God. And then I was not just witnessing, teaching from door to door. And they said, young man, where did you get this word from? Praise God. I said, from God. Praise God, my God. They said, have you been to theological college? I said, yes, the one in heaven. Praise God, my God. So, praise God. And then as I started reading the Bible, I knew how to locate the scripture, where it was, the verses and everything like that. And I first went, my first, praise God, you know, of course, it's a university now. I went to Shelton, praise God, University. Praise God, my God, in upstate New York. It was in Sloatsburg, New York. It's now in Florida. Praise God, my God. Dr. Buswell was the president there, but then it changed to Murray. But Murray was not like Dr. Buswell. Praise God, my God. He was prejudiced. Praise God, my God. And they hated Billy Graham because Billy Graham, praise God, my God, preached the gospel to everybody. And you know, Billy Graham never, praise God, had a segregated crusade. Praise God, my God. So, praise God, my God. I thank God for there. Then from there, I went to a myriad of schools. Praise God, my God, bless the Lord. I studied law. I studied medicine. Praise God, I studied social science. You name it. Praise God, I have 3 doctor's degrees. I don't know. praise God, a number of masters, and God knows how many bachelors. I didn't go to any commencement exercise. I didn't have time for that, praise God. The certificate, it just came incidentally, praise God, but what I wanted is the knowledge. From a small boy, I had a thirst for knowledge. My mother used to call me the why man. She used to tell me things, praise God, and I said, Mommy, why? Praise God. She said, why? Are you the why man? Praise God, my God. And her father said, tell him. You know, my grandfather only went formally to 2B. Praise God, primary 2, the second half. Praise God, my God. But he was a tailor. Praise God, Charleston, South Carolina. But you know, he was a self-educated man. He read. He was like an encyclopedia. You ask him anything, he'll tell you. Praise God, the answer. And thank God, you know, from 2B, he became the transportation manager of AMF, American Machine and Foundry, which was the biggest manufacturing company at that time. And he sent their stuff all over the world. Praise God, my God. He could quote, praise God, addresses from his head like, praise God, my God, like an encyclopedia. Praise God, my God. And I thank God for his life. But he, praise God, my God, was a great Bible teacher in the Azusa Street movement. He attended Salem, Praise God, Methodist Church, which is the biggest Methodist church in New York City that time, in Harlem, New York, praise God. And praise God, he was above the pastor in spirituality, praise God, my God. He taught people everywhere, praise God, my God. And I remember one of the pastors with the name Reverend Trigg. And he said, Reverend, why don't you stop your stupidness? He said, you're womanizing, you're drinking. He said, praise God, Mr. Tom, I know. He said, yes. He said, you don't know. Praise the Lord. But he was a straightforward man, but he loved people. Praise God. Anybody on the street, a drunk, drug addict, anybody, praise God. He said, hey, chief, he used to tip his hat. Praise God, my God. And they used to call him Mr. Tom, Mr. Richardson, praise God, at his home going. My God, people came from all over the world. They were inside and outside of that huge Methodist church. Praise God, that big pipe organ was going. Praise God, my God. I remember one, you know, because I just followed every step of him, praise God, before I got saved. And one woman from the West Indies, praise God, she said, praise God, she said, yes. She said, you look like granny. You talk like granny. You walk like granny. Praise the Lord. I can never forget that. And that was at the homegoing service. And I thank God, bless the Lord, praise God. You know, they used to sing that song, I love Jesus, I love Jesus, I love Jesus, I love Jesus, yes I do. And that big pipe organ would be pumping it out, praise God. Then they didn't have too many tambourines. They used to beat on the back of the hymn book, praise God. Used to wrap their canes on the floor, praise God, my God, in time to the music, praise God. But they were genuine. They were genuine. Thank God for those old saints. Praise God, my God. Now, you know, my grandfather on my mother's side, my grandmother on my father's side were a part of the Azusa Street Movement. But I came into the Azusa Street Movement 1952, the same year that the Azusa Street Movement moved from, praise God, Los Angeles, California to New York City. That one in Los Angeles, California is just a museum now. Praise God, it moved to New York City the same year, praise God, and a great revival broke out that year, praise God, in New York. And you had people like Bruce Gibson. Bruce Gibson used to belong to the Prendergast Syndicate, like Harry S. Truman. He was the first black man, praise God, to charter planes, carrying a big bag of opium across this nation, praise God. And he went to Spokane, Washington, praise God, my God. And he was about to do business with opium there, praise God, my God. And one tall, praise God, black mother came out of the church. And she put her arms around his shoulder and said, son, God loves you. He said, nobody ever told him that in his life. He said that melted his heart. She said, come on in the church. Praise God. God has something for you. He went in that church, gave his life to Christ completely. He came out of that church the next day. He stayed overnight in the church praying. Praise God. He came out of there. Next day, he crossed the Spokane River with that big bag of opium, threw it in the river. He said, thank God, I'm free. Praise God, my God. He met a gambler friend of his. Praise God, my God. As he was going across that bridge. And he said, Gibby, he said, we're having a hot game tonight. You know, that was poker. Praise God. He said, do you want to join us? He said, no. He said, I'm born again. And his friend said, Gibby, how long has it been since you've been born again? He said, 24 hours. His gambler friend said to him, if God can keep you for 24 hours, God can keep you for the rest of your life. He said, God bless you. Praise the Lord. And that's how he went to the other side of that bridge. Praise God, witnessing for God. Praise the Lord. And, you know, I had the privilege. You know, he moved to New York City, the Lower East Side. And I'll never forget that day. I preached at his church. And the message was, praise God, get your house in order for tomorrow you die. Praise God, my God bless you. When I gave the altar call, who was the first one to go to the altar but him? Praise God. And, you know, my knees melted. Praise God, my God bless you. I dropped down on my knees. I said, ah, God, praise God, I shall pray for him. Praise God, my God. And he said that God had been telling him to do something, and he didn't do it. Praise God, my God. But he said that day, he said, anything he says to do, I'm going to do it. Praise the Lord. So he did, and he became the pastor of one of our congregations, praise God, my God, on 111th Street in Harlem. Praise God. And I left him there, praise God, my God, bless the Lord, when I went to upstate New York, Connecticut. I don't know the year that God called him home. Because, you know, at that time, praise God, you know, the Azusa Street was 24 million people, praise God. Now, I was in my 20s when W.B. Wilson, who was the head of the Azusa Street movement in that time in the Bronx, New York, and he had a very big compound. They had a primary school, high school, they had a theological college, praise God, everything you can think of on that compound. He built it with his hands. He was a carpenter, like Jesus, praise God, my God. And he would build, praise God, my God, that big wooden cathedral during the day, praise God, my God, and at nighttime, praise God, my God, bless the Lord, he would preach, praise God. And when he preached, he would walk on the back of the pews from the front, praise God, my God, to the back of the church, never falling, praise God, my God. And by the time I met him, Reverend Mrs. Henrietta Peters, praise God, and Reverend Dr. Reginald Peters, who was late by that time. He died in 55, praise God, my God, in West Africa. Praise God, he went home to the Lord, praise God, my God. I won't call him late, I call him early, because he went home before us. Praise God. So what happened was, she invited me up there for a Sunday afternoon service, praise God, just to preach in the afternoon. And the thing turned into 2 weeks. You see people that backslid coming back to God, the deacons, stop sucking cigars, praise God, my God, bless the choir members, praise God, coming down, giving their life back to God, praise God, my God. And that lasted for 6 months. And I told him, Daddy, you see, I have to go now. I said, I'm a young evangelist. I can't stay at one place. He looked at me. He was about 100 at that time. You know, he couldn't come downstairs anymore. He was up over the wooden tabernacle. That's where he lived. They piped, you know, every sound up to him. You know, didn't have television or video, praise God, widespread in those days, praise God. So, praise God, he said to me, I said, no, son. He said, you can't go now, praise God. I said, Daddy, praise God. He said, listen to me. He said, you see all these things? He pointed me, you know, you could see from his window all the buildings. He said, you see all this? He said, you know, I'm too old. I'm ready to go home. He said, praise God, and you're the one to take care of it, praise God. I said, Daddy, I'm in my 20s. I said, praise God, I'm not able. He said something to me, praise God, that I'll never forget. He said, do you know one thing? He said, God is not looking for your ability. He's looking for your availability. He said, are you available? I said, what can I say? Praise the Lord. I'm always available to God. Praise the Lord. So that's how we took it over. Praise God, my God, bless the Lord. And we moved those headquarters to 2100 8th Avenue, even though we still had buildings there, praise God, but I operated from 2100 8th Avenue in Harlem. And that's where revival was going on. Praise God, my God. You see, as you know how holiness music is, praise God. And let me tell you, praise God, my God, outside of that place at 2100 8th Avenue, praise God, a big storefront, praise God, my God, you would see, praise God, my God, outside, drug addicts, alcoholics, praise God, the music was so good they was doing the jitterbug outside. Praise the Lord. And we always invite them in, praise the Lord. So we thank God in that same place, you know that was when Harlem was rough. Praise God, my God, there was, I would come into that place many nights and you see big fights, you know, with guns and knives. Praise God, my God. And I'd jump in between them. Praise God. I said, what are y'all trying to do? Kill each other? Praise God. I said, you'd be going to hell. Praise God. I'd take away the guns, the knives. And there was a place underneath the window, praise God, in that storefront. There was a big cabinet there, praise God. You see all the guns, the broken bottles, the knives that was in there. Praise God. I said, you're not getting this thing back. I said, this stuff belongs to God now. Praise the Lord. So, and I thank God, praise God. You see drug addicts come, God deliver them. Praise God, my God. I remember, praise God, my God, like one or two of them, Brother Monday, praise God, my God, and another brother. They would come in full of heroin, praise God, and pray for deliverance, say, I want to be free. They would spit the drugs right out on the rug. I said, spit it out, praise God, my God. Let it come, praise God. We didn't care about the rug. We cared about the person, praise the Lord. And they started following me all over, praise God, my giving their testimony, praise God. And I thank God for their life. Now, one of my father's in the Lord's was, you know, they call it Billy Roberts. Billy Roberts, not Oral Roberts, Billy Roberts, praise God, my God, and his wife. They were from the Midwest, praise God, my God. But Billy Roberts, praise God, my God, and it was a friend, Dad King. They used to be on the FBI's most wanted list. I'm telling you, they were, I'm telling you, criminals to the nth degree, praise God. God saved them. And you know, J. Edgar Hoover was, you know, like a dogged one, praise God, my God. And when God saved them, he gave them, they gave him their testimony. He said, boys, you're free. Praise the Lord, you're free. He said, I don't have any record against you anymore. Praise the Lord. And you know, they won many FBI agents, praise God, to the Lord. Praise God, because they never saw a turnaround like they did. And Billy, that was the soul saving station. It was over Frank's restaurant on 125th Street. That restaurant, later on, it belonged to Frank Lucas because he liked the name. His name was Frank. Praise God, my God, bless the Lord. And it belonged to Frank Lucas. If you ever saw that film, American Gangster, praise the Lord, my God, that was Frank Lucas. It was my cousin from North Carolina. Praise God, he was notorious. Praise God, my God. And the person he took over drugs from in Harlem was Bumpy Johnson. It was my other cousin, praise God, my God, from Charleston, South Carolina. When Bumpy died of a heart attack, he took over that operation. This guy used to go to Thailand, praise God, my God, and buy all the heroin there. And praise God, have the U.S. Army to fly it back. Praise God, my God, to you. You know, praise God, bless you. Let it be on record. The two biggest importers of drugs in the United States are the United States Army and the CIA. Praise God. That's why George Bush Sr., you check the old newspapers. Praise God. He and Noriega were the two biggest drug runners that America has ever known. Just like FDR, Praise God, my God, and Joe Kennedy with the two biggest booze runners, praise God, my God, doing prohibition. Praise God, my God, bless the Lord. They knew me, I knew them, praise God, my God, bless the Lord. But, you know, of course, I was not alive during the prohibition because I was born in 1938. But during the time they were running drugs, did you not hear that Oliver North, praise God, he traded, praise God, the Christian motivation speaker, he traded drugs for guns, praise God, my God. You know, praise God. And let me tell you, you know, when I preach the whole truth, praise God. I don't hold anything back, just like the Old Testament prophets. He said, if you know, the Bible says, praise God, cry loud, spare not, lift up your voice like a trumpet in Zion, tell my people of their transgressions and the house of Jacob their sins. And every apostle, every prophet has that mandate, praise God, my God. He cannot turn around, praise God. And they can't do anything to you, praise God. That's how the head of the mafia, praise God, my God, for New England, I thought it was just Rhode Island, he gave his life to Christ, praise God, my God. When God engulfed, praise God, Providence, praise God, my God, with the gospel, praise God, God claimed that city, praise God, my God, at the 2:30 broadcast, praise God, at the State House, and praise God, City Hall, all you heard was that music, Rosie Wallace in a mansion made of stone, in a shanty all alone. God cares. God cares. Praise God, my God. And I never, praise God, told a lie. Praise God. Even before I got saved, I couldn't lie. Praise God, my God. So the mayor, Joe Dorley, at that time, praise God, you know, if he was making a speech, he said, it's true. He said, if you don't believe it, ask Reverend Simmons. You know he don't lie. Praise the Lord. So I thank God that that has been my testimony. I ran the federal programs, model cities, praise God, interim assistance. I was coordinator. Praise God, my God, bless the Lord. And thank God I used, praise God, state, city, federal money to do missionary work, praise God, in this city. The earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. Praise God, my God, bless the Lord. And they, when the midday broadcast used to go on WRIB, praise God, my God, if I was running late, the mayor, everybody said, Rev, look, take my car, get there now. Praise the Lord. And I thank God. Praise God, my God. And God was able to win so many people. Praise God. And we've known them not just with the broadcast, on the street. Broad Street, praise God, at midnight. Praise God, my God. Blessed Lord, was my beat. You know, my church, we did rescue mission, praise God, my God. We did evangelism 24/7. Those that worked in the morning did evangelism in the afternoon. Those that worked in the afternoon did evangelism at night. And that night patrol is what I like, from 11 to about 2 or 3, because that's when everybody, praise God, my God, is living that shady life comes out, you see? All the prostitutes, the pimps, the drug addicts, praise God, the alcoholics, the homosexuals, they all. But you see, God loves them. The Bible says God so loved the world. And you know, praise God, when we went out there, praise God, my God, you see, people make a mistake. Praise God, by saying, oh, you drug addicts, oh, you come around, praise God, my God. They know who they are. They want to know how to stop being what they are, praise God, my God. And we go to them and let them tell their story. Praise God, that's the key thing in witnessing to people. Let them first tell their story. They're not out there by accident. There's a reason why they're out there. And when you, then they tell their story, praise God, then you can give your testimony why you were out there and what God did for you. Praise God, my God. If they were hungry, we said, come on. Praise God, what do you want? Donuts, hamburger, whatever it is. Praise God, you want some coffee? Praise God, my God. And you know, sometimes, praise God, that was the only meal they had, because drugs and alcohol, praise God, my God, was what they, praise God, my God, used to drinking, praise God, my God. And I thank God, bless the Lord, my God, for what God did. Praise God, my God. God is a wonderful God. Praise God, my God, bless the Lord. And just as this, my little friend, this dog is brought in, praise God, my God. Do you know, praise God, they have ears, praise God, my God. And things are recorded in their minds, in their eyes, praise God, and they will remember, praise God, my God. And I thank God, even babies in their womb, they hear in their mother's womb, huh? Praise the Lord, my God. So, you know, I thank God for all that God has done in my life, down during the years, praise the Lord, my God. And I can thank God, praise God, my God, that not only did God save me, October 12, 1952, He saved me, He sanctified, He filled me with the Holy Ghost, praise God, that same day, praise God, because my father in the Lord, Reverend Dr. Henry Brooks, praise God, a little short black preacher from Oklahoma, praise God, my God, and I, you know, used to come to the house to witness. I went to that church purposely to give my life to Christ that Sunday morning. And I can never forget, praise God, because all that Saturday night, I wrestled, praise God, my God, with myself. I was under conviction. I said, I'm going tomorrow morning, praise God, my God, and give my life to Christ. And you know, one of the things that motivated me, I prayed. I asked God for a little sister. It was only my brother and myself. He's 2 years older than me at that time, praise God. And praise God, my God, I said, God, I want a little sister. I said, God, if you give me a little sister, praise God, I'm going to stop all of this life. How can I raise her? Praise God, my God, bless her. And my life was like this, praise God, my God. And I prayed when I was 14 years old. My mother got pregnant, praise God, my God, at 45, praise God, my God, and she gave us a little sister. Praise God, Wendy, praise God, my God, is her name. You know, I taught Wendy how to read and write when she was 2 years old. Today, she's a senior professor at New York City University. But she doesn't like to teach on the campus. She goes around teaching people who are dropouts from school, praise God, former drug addicts, former alcoholics. And all of New York City says she's the best teacher they've ever seen. Praise God, my God. And you know, when you give your best to God, that's when it counts. Praise the Lord. And I thank God. You know, I wanted to come to Africa with me, but God had her beat in New York City. Praise the Lord, my God. But I thank God. Praise God. You know, my first wife that I married, praise God, in 1960. Praise God, my God. She, praise God, my God, came from West Virginia. Praise God, my God. And when God called me to Africa, she said, I'll never go. I hate Africa. Praise God. I'll never go there. Praise God. I said, well, God bless you. I'll see you in heaven. Praise God. I said, because I'm going. Praise the Lord, my God. And I left. Praise God, my God. And God allowed me to live a holy life. You see, that's the key. Holiness without, no man shall see the Lord. Praise God, my God. I was there without a wife for 28 years. Praise God, my God, bless the Lord. And nobody can say, name my girlfriend. When I go around the world to preach, I say, if anybody knows the name of my girlfriend, stand up and tell it. Not heard it yet. Praise the Lord. And that's the key, living holy life. Because holiness without, no man shall see the Lord. Praise God. You see, the Bible tells us, praise God, my God, bless the Lord, that God needs to, we need to abstain from all appearance of evil. And the very God of peace sanctify you wholly. I pray, God, your whole spirit and soul and body be preservedless unto the coming of the Lord. You know, praise God, the Bible says there were 10 virgins, praise God, my God, in the book of Matthew. 5 were wise and 5 were foolish. The foolish ones never went up in the rapture because they just went halfway. They just got, praise God, born again. They just got partly sanctified. They didn't have the Holy Ghost, praise God, and they didn't go on to perfection. Praise God, because Jesus said He's coming back in Ephesians 5:27 for glorious church without spot, wrinkle, or blemish, or any such thing. Not a church that's getting ready, a church that's already ready. Praise God, my God, because the foolish virgins, they were not ready. Praise God, my God, bless the Lord. And they just went halfway. They were just converted. They didn't get sanctified all the way. Praise God, my God. Because sanctification is spirit, soul, and body. Every part of us. Praise God, my God. And praise God, my God, this is a lesson for today. Nobody can go to heaven unless they're in that glorious church. Praise God, perfected when He comes back for a church. Not a church that's getting ready, but a church that's already ready. That's why, praise God, my God, you know, when I took over the Azusa Street Movement, praise God, as the last remaining apostle of the Azusa Street Movement today, praise God, there were only 25 million. Today, there are 65 million. That's adults. I don't know how many children. Praise God. When the Bible says Jesus said, fed 4,000, He fed 5,000 men. Who knows how many children, praise God, my God, and their wives. Praise God, my God. But I thank God today that Azusa Street is everywhere. And now the headquarters of Azusa Street is in, praise God, Ibadan, Nigeria, the largest city in Africa. You know where, praise God, my great-grandparents, their great-great-grandparents, they are the ones that started it. Praise God, they were never in the colonial church. They were never in Catholicism. They were never in Anglicanism. They were never in the colonial church. Praise God, my God. They had not even seen any Europeans. Praise God, until they passed through Liberia and Sierra Leone in 1846. Landed in Utahville, South Carolina. They had to drop their African names because slavery was going on. Praise God, my God. So they just took on names of free people. Praise God. And I thank God for their life. Reverend Seymour, William Seymour, he was from Louisiana. He met them in Texas. And he was their student. And he took that message of salvation, sanctification, the baptism of the Holy Ghost, praise God, perfection, signs, miracles, and wonders, praise God, to Azusa Street in Los Angeles, California. The first church that invited him, when he got them, they closed the doors, locked the doors against him, praise God, my God. But God, they went into a livery stable, praise God, my God, where they used to have horses downstairs. And you know, the first building they went into before that, I mean, they were shouting and dancing, praise God, and the four gave away, praise God. So they had to find this livery stable, praise God, my God. And that's where Azusa Street, praise God, the museum is today, praise God, but the headquarters now is in Ibadan, Nigeria, praise God, where it all started, praise God. Now, on my father's side, he came to America, praise God, before on my mother's side, praise God, my God, he was an Egyptian imam at the University of Alexandria, the oldest university in the world, the oldest library in the world, praise God, my God, and he, praise God, my God, read the Bible in Aramaic and in English. He read the Quran in Aramaic and in English. They were written in Aramaic, the first Sanskrit language. Praise God, my God. He said, this Quran has no savior, no plan of salvation. This Bible does. He got converted. Then in 1840, 6 years before, praise God, my ancestors on the other side, he came to America and he was a minister, praise God, my God. He was a missionary to the Native Americans, praise God, my God, who are originally from Egypt. You know, when you go, praise God, my God, you will see, praise God, bless the Lord. You will see, praise God, my God, that you will see that the pyramids in Central America and Mexico, they are just like the pyramids in Egypt. When I went there, praise God, 10 years ago, your wife is from there, praise God. When I went there, it was 15 years ago, I remember, praise God, my God, we had revival. The people were ready for God. You know, I was not even scheduled to go to Mexico City. I was up in, praise God, I was up in Montreal, Canada. There was one sister, Sister Maria. She worked for the government. She worked for Pemex, praise God, my God, the oil, praise God, company of Mexico. And she said, you know, I speak Spanish, so she was saying, Reverendo, you have to go to Mexico, praise God. I said, praise God, my dear, I'm scheduled to go back to Nigeria now. I really don't have the time. She said, you have to go. She said, ask God, praise God, if you should go. I asked God, said, God, yes, you have to go, praise the Lord. So it was the most harrowing 10 days I ever went through in my life. Praise God, I arrived there on Saturday night. And praise God, my God, the next day they took me to the largest gospel church. It used to be, it was a converted warehouse. It held 6,000 people. And the place was jam-packed. Praise God, my God. And I ministered to them, praise God, my God. And many got saved, the lame walked, the deaf heard, the blind saw, praise God. After that first service, the pastor was telling me, I have 10 minutes. I'm looking at him. I said, 10 minutes to do what? He said, there's another crowd outside waiting to come in. Praise the Lord. And I ministered the same thing to them. I laid hands on everybody. Praise God, my God. Then he's telling me, I have 15 minutes. I said, this man is crazy. Praise the Lord, my God. He said, you want tea or coffee? Praise God, my God. He said, there's another crowd, another 6,000. We're waiting to come in to jam-pack the place. After that third service, ministering to them. Praise God, my God. Sister Consuelo said, let's go. There's another church. The service has already started. Praise God, my God. Let's go to this place. Praise God, my God. And we went to this place. The hill was so steep, it looked like a wall. It looked like, praise God, in West Virginia, where my wife came from. And this pastor came down in a little red car. Praise God, my God. Sister Consuelo looked at that hill. She said, I'll walk up. I said, look, I might as well ride. He does this every day. Praise the Lord, my God. And we rode up. When we got there, we heard, praise God, the drums played like I've never heard them play before. It was his 13-year-old daughter inside playing those drums. The service had started, praise God, my God, and it was on fire for God. Praise God, my God. When we got finished there, she said, Reverendo, we're going to the next place. The service has already started. And we went to place after place until 1 o'clock in the morning. And when we were going home, 1 o'clock in the morning, praise God, there was a group out on a square, like a roundabout, praise God, my God, and they had a banner up, praise God, revolution, praise God, and our motto, praise God, my God, for revival in Nigeria, praise God, that year was holiness, Holy Ghost, revolution. And she said, Reverendo, you want to minister to them? I said, Sister Consuelo, give them tracks. I'm going home to sleep. Praise the Lord. So we, but every day for the next 10 days, we went through the same thing. Praise God, they wake me up 5 o'clock in the morning. Praise God, my God, to preach to drug addicts. Praise God, and to preach to alcoholic programs. And that lasted for that 10 days. The last 2 days, they will follow me down the streets in Mexico City, said, pray for me, pray for me. I said, Jesus, I had to duck in the alley like Jesus did. Praise God, to get away. Praise the Lord. And they followed me to the airport. Praise God, my God. And they said, Reverend, when are you coming back? I said, I will be back. I didn't tell them the day nor the year, but I said, I will be back. Praise the Lord. So, but I thank God, since then I have sons and daughters that have gone to minister there. Reverend Dr. Shegamadi Koya, praise God, one of my sons who was an orphan in Nigeria, praise God. He, praise God, my God, is training missionaries all over the world. Praise God, my God. So he went to Mexico. Joe Ramacheri, praise God, my God. One of my sons from Italy that ministered in Montreal, he went there to minister. I said, God, thank you. I am back, praise God, my God, through my children. Praise the Lord. And I thank God, praise God, my God, and I bless the Lord for everything. Now, praise God, the greatest revival, praise God, that I've seen going on is in Nigeria. You know, we planted 6,000 branches in Nigeria since January 3rd, 1983. And we have the largest theological system in the world. Praise God, my God. Since January 3rd, 1983, over 13 million people have passed through our theological school system. You know, the population of Nigeria, you know, it's the largest black nation in the world. And the population of Nigeria is going to 180 million. And you know, that 13 million is not even, I'm not satisfied. It's not 10%. Praise God. I want to see at least 100. I want to see at least 18 million. Praise God, my God, through there. And you know, right now, I want to go back. Praise God, my God. I'll be going back. Praise God, my God. Praise God, my God, next month, the beginning of next month. But now we have the very big orphanage. Praise God. Do you know the Chibok orphans? Praise God, my God. The Chibok girls and those orphans from Maiduguri. We took them in. Praise God, my God. Bless the Lord. And some of them are growing. Some of them are back in Nigeria because they've cleared the area where that Boko Haram was. Praise God, my God. And these other Chibok girls, I'm going there. I'm going to negotiate with Boko Haram. Praise God, my God. Because if God cannot do it, it can't be done. Praise God, my God. Some of them, they have real grievances. Praise God, my God. But you know how that started. Praise God. It started because, praise God, my God, the Fulanese people who are nomads, they bought land, praise God, my God, from Praise God, my God, the Burum people and from the Hausa people. Praise God, my God, the Burum people were supposed to be Christians. The Hausa people were supposed to be Muslims. Praise God, my God. And they bought land from them, but after they paid for the land, they wouldn't give them the land. They said they don't want them in their local politics. You know, they were nomads. And everybody gets tired just wandering around, praise God, my God. And they didn't give them the land. But Bangida, praise God, my God, let it be known, praise God, my God. But Bangida is a former head of state. What he did, praise God, my God, he raised up this Boko Haram, he and Atiku Abubakar. Praise God, they raised up Boko Haram. Praise God, my God, bless the Lord. And for political reasons, praise God. And praise God, my God, you know, Babangid is an evil genius. I'm just telling you. Praise God, my God. You know, I was a, praise God, my God, advisor to the Nigerian government. But under Babangid, I refused. Under the last president before this one, praise God, you know, they call him Good Luck Jonathan. I call him Bad Luck. Praise God, my God, bless you. I refused. Praise God, my God. But my friend, General Buhari, praise God, my God, bless the Lord. And you know, it was the Dearborn of Buhari that brought discipline to Nigeria for the first time. Praise God, my God, bless the Lord. And they elected him as president. Praise God, they, you know, this Bad Luck Jonathan, all these people, PDP, they did everything they could to keep him from getting in. Praise God, Obasanjo that started PDP, praise God, when they became too corrupt, he left PDP, he tore up his membership card, praise God, on television and said, this is not the PDP that I started. He's the one that recommended Buhari because he was a general, praise God, like Buhari was. Praise God, my God. And he, Obasanjo, is now born again Christian. He went to theological college, praise God, he graduated. He's a born again Christian, praise God. So Buhari, who is a Muslim, praise God, chose a pastor to be his running mate, praise God, my God. A born-again Christian, praise God, and a lawyer, praise God. Now, Buhari was very smart. He used to be, praise God, my God, bless the Lord. Those of you that don't know Nigeria, let me tell you. He used to be, praise God, my God, the Minister of Finance, was the Minister of Petroleum. He knows what to do. He was the head of Petroleum Trust Fund. Praise God, he knows what to do. And he hated corruption. And I know things are going to change. You're not going to see Boko Haram. It's going to be out. All these old generals, praise God, and some of them are born again. I'm going, and I will negotiate with them, praise God, because there was another, praise God, group, praise God, terrorist group called Matasini in the Middle Belt. Praise God, my God, around Jaws. Praise God. All the Middle Belt, that was in 1985, praise God, my God. And I, praise God, my God, went there, praise God, my God. You know, for crusade, praise God, the person that went before me, the evangelist that went 5 years before me, he went there, praise God, the first thing that came out of his mouth was Muhammad went to hell. That's not what God called him there to preach. They stoned him to death. The first thing that came out of our mouth was we're here because God loves you and we love you. See people come down from the mountains, praise God, with their lanterns at night. Praise God, my God. And Matasini and everybody, praise God, my God. On the first night, over 3,000 souls got saved, praise God, more than the day of Pentecost. At the end of that meeting, that was the end of Matasini, praise God, my God. If God doesn't do it, it cannot be done, praise the Lord. And that's the thing, you know, God needs to save these Boko Haram boys, praise God, my God, and girls, because they're blind. They don't know what they're doing. Praise God, my God. And God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten. God loves them too. Praise God, my God. Bless you. And God wants to change their life. If God can change my life, praise God, as a hoodlum, a criminal on the streets of Harlem in New York, what life could not God change? Praise the Lord. You see, I was a murderer like the Apostle Paul. Praise God. But God so loved the world. Praise God, my God, bless the Lord. And there's nobody that God cannot change. Now, we need prayer. You know, we have an orphanage in Nigeria. But our church, praise God, my God, bless the Lord, in Ghana. Pastor and Pastor Mrs. Fletcher. Praise God, my God. They, Praise God, my God, they are faithful. Praise God, when they went back to Ghana after training at our theological, praise God, my God, bless the Lord, a college in Nigeria, praise God, my God, their family promised them everything, praise God, to help them in the ministry. They gave them nothing. Only one brother who had many houses gave them a house, praise God, to live in and to run the orphanage. Praise God, but he was so stingy, he wouldn't give it to them. He had many houses. He lost all, and he lost that one. So now they don't have a building. They said, Papa, is there any non-governmental organization that you can get help? I said, I don't know any, son. Praise God, I said, but I'm coming there. We're going to build that orphanage. I don't know where I'm going to get the money from, but God knows where I'm going to get the money from. Praise God, my God. The Bible says, suffer little children, come unto me, and forbid them not, for of such is the kingdom of heaven. And let me tell you, praise God, my God, that building, praise God, just like all the buildings on our headquarters compound, is going to be built. Praise God, my God, we have so much land in Ibadan, praise God, my God, that if we put those lands together, we can have our own little town. Praise God, my God, and that's what's going to happen in Ghana. Praise God, my God, I was there, we saw a revival, praise God, my God, so we have to have follow-up. Praise God, my God. So, praise God, I want you to pray for me as I go back, praise God, because these orphans are our future. You know, praise God, Bose Adekoya, praise God, my God, and her brothers, there was five of them. Praise God, my God, their father died when their mother was 40 years old. She said, Papa, does that mean I shouldn't marry again? I'm a young woman. I said, listen, praise God, you can marry again, but only in the Lord. Praise God, and I said to her, praise God, my God, bless you. Now, you remember your husband was Aladura. You know that's a juju witchcraft church. Praise God, my God. And I said, you could only come to church in the afternoon on Sunday. You had to go to that Aladura church, you and your children. Praise God, on Sunday morning. I said, now that he's gone, you're free. I said, if you want to go somewhere and fast and pray for 2 weeks, you're free. Praise God, my God. I said, are you willing to give up that freedom to go into marriage again? She just laughed. Praise God, she never married again until she went home to be with the Lord. She was of a royal family from a Barracuda. Praise God, my God. She was, praise God, my God, bless the Lord, a traditional ruler. Praise God, my God. And let me tell you, at her homegoing service, you know, I wasn't even there. I saw the video because I was scheduled to leave Nigeria the time that they was doing a homegrown service. I said, the church, the cathedral is yours. You people know what to do. Praise God, my God. I saw the video. That place, you know, holds 17,000 with the overflow. That place was jam-packed all outside the gates, down the road. I'm telling you, praise God, my God, you never saw that many people with kings, princes, so many crowns. Praise God, my God, so many commissioner police. Praise God, my God, so many government ministers. My God, in her, just like Samson, in her death, she did more than in her life. Praise God, my God. And you know, praise God, my God, bless the Lord. Thank God for her life. Praise God. They asked me, praise God, her son, the oldest boy, Shechem. He said, Papa, can we bury her on the cathedral grounds? Praise God. I said, praise God, that is where she's going to be buried. Praise God, my God, bless the Lord. And you know, there in Nigeria, praise God, my God, if you have a church, especially a cathedral, if you don't have a burial ground, praise God, people want to know who's going to bury me. Praise God, who's going to marry my children. A fellowship will not just fly. Praise God, I said, that is her spot. Praise God. She used to say, Papa, I'm your firstborn here in Nigeria. I said, no, Mommy, you're the firstborn traditional person here. She said, no, I'm your firstborn. I said, okay, praise God. But she's buried there. Praise God, my God. And you know, I don't bury the saints where the sinners are buried. You know why? Because their bodies are sacred. Praise God. You realize Elijah, praise God, that spirit stayed even in his bones. Do you understand? And when Elijah, praise God, my God, bless the Lord, was raised, praise God, you know, Elijah, praise God, that Israeli soldier, praise God, that got killed during that battle, they opened Elisha's tomb and threw him in. when his body hit Elisha's bone, boom, he came back alive. Praise God, my God. So that spirit, that anointing is still on those bones, even as down the bones in that body. So they should not be buried where the sinner should be buried. Praise God, my God. And I make a difference. Praise God, my God. Because when, praise God, my God, that person is going to be raptured, it's right from that spot. Praise God, my God. That spirit stays on them. Praise God. And I don't let people sit on the grave. I don't let them stand there. Praise God. I don't let them dry clothes there. Nothing. Praise God, my God. It's a hallowed spot. Praise God, and I thank God. And that's the way it is. And that's the way it should be here. Praise God, my God. But you know now, you know these graveyards are so big. And the big church is here. You know they don't have room for graveyards anymore. Praise God. And there's only a certain place where you can bring. But thank God, Africa, where the church started, is still like that again. Praise God, my God. Egypt, Libya, Ethiopia, and even Israel itself is a matter of the main continent of Africa. Praise God. We had the gospel first. We rejected it first and went to paganism. Praise God, my God. But now, praise God, things have become full circle. What's happening in Africa, not happening everywhere, anywhere in the world. In Nigeria, the largest number of people who are coming to Christ, praise God, university students. The largest number of people entering the ministry are university professors. That's not happening anywhere else in the world. Praise God, my God, bless you. South Africa too. Praise God, there's a pastor there, Pastor Irene. Her mentor, praise God, my God, is from Harlem, where I came from the Azusa Street movement. Praise God. And if you see her on Dish TV, it's a dynamic woman. No makeup, no jewelry, conservative dressing, no trousers. Praise God, my God. She has a powerful message. She just calls devils out. Come out. Praise God, my God. I saw, praise God, one woman crawling around on the grass, eating grass like an animal. She said, stand up. Praise God, my God, bless her. And that woman stand up, praise God. She said, come here. Praise God. She said, I didn't want to be here. Praise God. That's what the girl said. She said, but you're here. Praise God. She said, come here. Praise God, my God. She said, in Jesus' name, you devils come out. Praise God. She fell down. She got up a brand new person. Praise God in the Lord. Praise God, my God. I can never forget. Praise God, many years ago, Florence Martin. She was one of the biggest, praise God, dope, praise God, heroin people, praise God, my God, in Chicago. Mm-hmm. And Florence Martin came to Harlem, praise God, my God, with her sister Jenny. And I was running, praise God, meeting at St. Mark's United in His Holiness Church. And that night, she said as she was passing, God was drawing her up into that church because the church was upstairs. Praise God, my God. And her sister said, no, don't go up there. Don't go up there. She said, leave me alone. Praise God, I'm going up there. She said, I'm going to go where you go. Praise God, my God. And she went up. Praise God. That night, Florence Martin looked like State Street Sadie. All that makeup and everything she had on. Praise God, my God. And let me tell you, when God, praise God, my God, God was moving on her through the message. Praise God, my God. And when I gave the altar call, she didn't come at first. I said, listen, God is calling you. Praise God, she came up. Praise God, she started crying. God took those tears and washed her face. Her face looked, glowed like an angel. Praise God, my God, bless her. And she gave her life to Christ. Praise God, my God. Her sister Jenny didn't follow her right away. She went home. She was one of the biggest, praise God, my God, heroin, praise God, man, cocaine sellers, praise God, my God, in Chicago, where, praise God, my God, you know, where Barack Obama was growing up, praise God. And she went home in Harlem that night, and she threw that drugs down the toilet, I'm telling you, and said, it's over. Her sister Jenny said, how are we going to live? She said, by the grace of God, praise the Lord. And you saw her face, she looked like an angel. Praise God, my God. The next year, she became one of America's leading evangelists, praise God. I've not seen her since that time, but I know God is probably still using her if she's still alive. Praise God. And I thank God. God is doing it over and over again. Praise God. In Nigeria, in Ghana, praise God. I was teaching in Ghana on the baptismal places. I didn't even get finished teaching. The Holy Ghost fell and they started speaking in tongues. I said, wait a minute, God. Praise God. I'm not finished. He said, sit down. Praise God. Praise the Lord. And so I thank God. All we can do is do what God asks us to do and let God be God. Praise God, my God. And let me tell you, the Azusa Street Movement is alive and well. All around the world, 65 million. Praise God, my God. And that's adults. I don't know how many children. Praise God, my God. We even have, praise God, a church in China. Huh? Praise God. And the pastor is Chinese. Praise God. You know, because in China, praise God, they don't care. You can open a church, but the person that is running that church has to be a national Chinese. Praise God. And he is. Thank God for his life. He used to be a professor at Peking. Praise God, my God, bless you. But praise God, my God, you know, he was in Nigeria. He was, praise God, my God, he was, I think he was Secretary of Commerce and Industry for the Chinese Embassy. Praise God, my God. And I met him, praise God, my God, because Colonel Makachuola from the 2nd Mechanized Division, praise God, my God, he wanted to buy alum from China, praise God, my God, to clear the drinking water. Praise God, my God. So I introduced him to him, praise God, and he showed Colonel Makachuola, praise God, how to run his big farm, how to preserve the stuff. You know, the Chinese are very good in that. Praise God. And, praise God, my God, he told me, he said, Bishop, he said, well, you know, I'm working for a communist, praise God, country. He said, but when I go back, he said, I want to do what you're doing. I said, you know what I'm doing? He said, yes, praise God, my God. He said, I'm going to be a missionary. He said, my grandmother was Roman Catholicism, but my, praise God, mother was a born-again Holy Ghost filled Christian. He said, and that's what I'm going to do. I said, God bless you, son. Praise God. And that's what he's doing today. You know, I have place, there are places around the world I don't even know where Azusa Street, praise God, has sprung up, and they're contacting me. You know, that's why, praise God, I have about 8 phones. Praise God, cell phones, and they can call me from anywhere. Praise God, my God. I even have, praise God, phones that have television. Praise God, my God. And I'm not paying for the television. Praise God, my God. And I can see what's happening, praise God, in their land. I can see revival. Praise the Lord. And I thank God. Praise God. I thank God for technology. What you're seeing now, praise God, from this recording is technology. Praise God, my God. And I thank God for you young people running this technology. Now, you see, I have 3 doctorates. Praise God, my God. I have, praise God, even 4. Praise God, I have a number of bachelors. I have a number, praise God, of masters. And you know, most of these graduation ceremonies, I didn't even go. Praise God. You know, the certificate is just given to me, praise God, for studying. All I want is the knowledge. And you know, at the age of 77, I'm still studying. Praise God. You know, when I got my PhD in petrochemistry, praise God, my God, the chemistry book, praise God, the element chart was only 103 elements. Today, they're over 300, praise God, from 103. That means that book is redundant. I keep studying. I'm upgrading. Praise God, my God. When you stop studying, praise God, you're finished. Praise the Lord, my God. Keep your brain alive. Praise God. Study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. Praise God, my God. Bless the Lord. And 2 Timothy 2:15, the greatest science book in the world is the Bible. Praise God, my God, bless God. Everything it says proves out. Praise God. Noah's Ark is still on the mount, the top of Mount Ararat. Praise God. It was discovered in the 1930s, praise God, by a Russian pilot. Praise God. When he got back, they said, shh, don't tell anybody. But you can go up there today. You still see Noah's Ark. The dimensions are the same type of wood, praise God, as a testimony. Praise God, my God. God's word is true. Praise God, my God. Bless the Lord. And let us rely on God's word. And the Bible says in the last day there will be a famine, but not for bread, not for water, but for the word of God. Praise God, my God. So let us study God's word. You know, as Christians, you know, the Jehovah's Witness, they don't have the right message. but they have the right method. We are supposed to go from door to door, praise God, teaching the word of God, for he, that's his general commandment. Praise God, go ye forth in all the world and teach all nations, praise God, to observe all things whatsoever I've commanded you. Praise God, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son, Holy Ghost, not Holy Spirit, Holy Ghost, that's his name. Praise God, my God. And he said, lo, I'm with you always unto the end of the world. That's the promise first that he said, I'm with you. Praise God. And if we do it, he'll be with us. Praise God, to the end of this world. So I praise God for your pastor, for your life, for your vision. Praise God, my God, bless the Lord. And you know, they want me to write a book about the street movement, but I don't have time to write. I'm too busy living it. Praise God. So through our broadcast and through recordings like this, it will go on and on and on. Praise God, for years. So God bless you. Praise God. Praise God, Brother Jim. Praise God. God bless you. Praise God, my God, for introducing me to my son here. Praise God, my God. You know, just like I went to Baltimore, and they were introducing me to a bishop that was from Liberia. They said, we want you to meet him. Praise God. When I saw him, I said, I knew you before you knew me. I knew you when you were a little boy. Praise the Lord, my God. He said he was shocked. Praise God. I told him who raised him. I told him where his church was in Liberia. Praise God, my God. And I told him that his pastor in Providence is Sister Patricia. Praise God, my God. He said, Lord. He said, he was so grateful. He said, Papa, pray for me. And I prayed. Praise God. He said, I won't be the same anymore. Praise God. I said, you know. Praise God, my God. And I want to get him to sponsor. Praise God, my God. One of for his convention. I want him to sponsor. Praise God, my God. Bless the Lord. Praise God, my God. A bishop from Nigeria called Bishop Afolabi. He's my technical man. He's great in technical things. He's solar power, praise God, all kind. He revamps the electricity from the whole building. Refrigeration, praise God, air conditioning, you name it. Praise God, my God, he can do it. Praise God, my God, and he does it freely as unto the Lord. Praise God, my God. And we have big solar lights there on our compound now that come on by themselves. Praise God, my God, at the dusk, and goes on when the sunlight blows up. Praise God, my God. And he's a blessing. Praise God, my God. His name is Bishop George Afolabi. Praise God, my God. When he comes to the U.S., I want you to receive him. Praise God, my God. He's a good man. Praise the Lord. And I thank God for his life. And I thank God for your life. Praise God, my God. Praise God, Sister Lori. I thank God for her life, committed unto the Lord. And I pray that God will continue to use you. Praise God, because you are sons and daughters. You are future. Praise God, my God. And people will join you. Praise God, my God. And Azusa Street goes on and on till Jesus Christ comes. God bless you. Amen. Amen.